the revelation of the Son of God, Jesus, the King of Israel. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Peace to the 12 tribes of Israel that are scattered abroad. Grace to you and peace to you. My name is Casey Barthel with Israel Productions. Israel Productions is inspired by God, and our mission is to give God Almighty the praise daily for that holy name, and to celebrate the promise God made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That great promise was made by God Almighty and fulfilled by God Almighty. Give thanks today for what our Father in heaven has created through the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. As it is written in the Holy Scriptures, Isaiah 43 and 15. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. And what a mighty and awesome King he is. We all know that there is only one God. His word brought forth all things, seen and unseen. All power is in his hand. He is truly God alone. God Almighty, I pray that you give us more understanding that we may know you. Revelations 4 and 1. After these things I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice I heard was like a trumpet, speaking with me, saying, come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this. Immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne sit in heaven, and one sit on the throne. And he who sat there was like a jasper, a sardius stone in appearance. And there was a rainbow around the throne, in appearance like an emerald. Around the throne were 24 thrones. And on the throne I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white robes. And they had crowns of gold on their heads. And from the throne proceeded lightnings, thunderings, and voices. Seven lamps of fire were burning before the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. Before the throne, there was a sea of glass like crystal. And in the midst of the throne and around the throne were four living creatures, full of eyes in front and in back. The first living creature was like a lion. The second living creature like a calf. The third living creature had a face like a man. And the fourth living creature was like a flying eagle. The four creatures, each having six wings, were full of eyes around and within. And they do not rest day or night, saying, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to him who sit on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who sit on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, you are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created. He is truly God alone. Let all praise and honor be given to God Almighty, who created all things for his will. My Father in heaven, we know you are a powerful spirit, and by your word alone everything was brought forth, including your Son, Jesus, who you anointed to rule over your people, Israel. Today we ask for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding about the revelation of your Son, Jesus, the King of Israel. Revelations 19 and 11. Now I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he who sat on him was called faithful and true, and in righteousness he judges and make war. His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. All power is in the Word of God. The Word of God is real. We live by the Word of God. We will die by the Word of God. And those that believe and obey the Word of God will live forever according to the Word of God. John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. This man came for a witness, to bear witness to the light, that all through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believed in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. All praise and honor goes to the Father. Give thanks today for the Holy Word of God. The Holy Spirit teaches me that the Word of God came first. Because of the Word of God, I believe in Abraham. Because of the Word of God, I believe in Moses. Because of the Word of God, I believe that Jesus was chosen by God to fulfill his holy word. Revelation chapter 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants things which must shortly take place. And he sent and signified it by his angels to his servant John, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, to all things that he saw. Blessed is he who reads and those who hear the words of this prophecy and keep those things which are written in it, for the time is near. Revelation chapter 1, verse 9. I, John, both your brother and companion in tribulations and kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was on the island that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice as of a trumpet saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. He is truly the first and last of his kind, the greatest among men, Jesus, the Son of God. Verse 12. Then I turned to see the voice that spoke with me. And having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the feet, and girdled about the chest with a golden band. His head and hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes like a flame of fire. His feet were like fine brass, as if refined in a furnace, and his voice as of the sands, as of the sound of many waters. He had in his right hand seven stars. Out of his mouth went a two-edged sword, and his countenance was like the sun shining in his strength. This testimony is to give God Almighty the praise for the revelation of his holy word through his only begotten Son, Jesus. We all know that God created all things for his purpose. He created man and gave him all the things of the earth. But as you know, man disobeyed the word of God, which brought the curse of God upon all mankind. Because of the disobedience of our forefathers, God Almighty plagued the earth with evil spirits, that man may learn to choose good over evil. Revelations 12 and 3. And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great, fiery red dragon, having seven heads and ten horns, and seven diadems on his head. His tail drew a third of the stars of heaven, and threw them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth, to devour the child as soon as it was born. She bore a male child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up to God and his throne. Verse 7. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought, but they did not prevail, nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the great dragon was cast out, that serpent of old, called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast to the earth, and his angels was cast out with him. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ have come. For the accuser of our brethren, who accused them before God day and night, has been cast down, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives to death. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time. O great and awesome God of Israel, we see the works of Satan and his angels. We thank you for your mercy. We give honor to you for your grace. We bow down and praise you forever. Amen. My brothers, my sisters, we are living in the last days, and we must stay true to the word of God so that we may be able to stand against the wicked ways of Satan and his angels. Revelations 13 and 11. Then I saw another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb and spoke like a dragon. And he exercised all authority of the first beast in his presence, and causes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. He performed great signs, so that he even makes fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And he deceives those who dwell on the earth by these signs which he was granted to do in the sight of the beast, telling those who dwell on the earth to make an image to the beast, who was wounded by the sword and lived. He was granted power to give breath to the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause as many as would not worship the image of the beast to be killed. He calls all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their foreheads, and that no one may buy or sell except one who has the mark of the name of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him who has understanding calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. His number is 666. I am not 100% sure of the meaning of the number 666, but I believe it is all the blasphemous names that man has called himself since Adam. My people, we must live only by the word of God that proceeds from the mouth of God, so we do not become victims of deceit. Revelations 14 and 6. Then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on the earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, "Fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come, and worship him who made heaven and earth, the sea, and springs of water." In closing, I am thankful to God Almighty for my health and strength, and I am especially thankful that he has opened my eyes and my ears to his truth. My name is Casey Barthel, and may the word of God be in your heart forever. Revelations 21. Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eye. There shall be no more death, no sorrow, no crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away." Then he who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said to me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the foundation of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the cowardly, unbelieving, abominable, murderers, sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death." Israelites, this is the word of God. Peace.
Tell one more person, if you're looking for somebody, he's gone. And he don't need nobody else. There's no question of your greatness, no searching of your power. Oh, the wonder of your glory. To you 40 years is but 1 hour. Your knowledge is all encompassing. To your wisdom there is no end. Oh, for you alone, my God. You are God alone. Your mercy is everlasting. Your truth is here always. You are He who was and is to come. Who is He that can number your days? You flung the sun to burn in space, and the night's moon bows light from day. Oh, you alone. You're God, you're God, Elohim, you're everything I need. You are God alone. Now unto the King, eternal.
Thankful today, my people, for God Almighty. Be thankful today, my people, for God Almighty has chosen Jesus to fulfill His word. Revelations 22:16. I, Jesus, have sent my angels to testify to you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright and morning star. And the spirit and the bride say, come. And let him who hears say, come. And let him who thirsts come. Whoever desires, let him take the water of life.